Well, guys, I'm finally going to start building it. It's only been, I don't know, a year since I got it. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. I have nothing to do. It's Saturday night. I'm drinking Diet Coke and ice water. So, let's see how much I can get done. Well, here it is. It's 10 to 6. This is all the further I've made it. Not exactly the easiest car to put together. Mostly because the instructions are... Well, they're not really instructions. It's just an exploded view. Which is fine. You know, it doesn't say step one, do this. Step two, do that. It just shows how everything goes together. Problem is that some things have to be put together before other things. So you end up taking stuff back apart. But, and I gotta remember, open the bag when it tells me, so I had to circle it, because I just didn't see it. But, anyway, my favorite bag's coming up. D-bag. So, anyway, I'm about 6 Diet Cokes in. I'm not drinking any alcohol tonight, because this stuff's so fiddly and so small, and my vision's so shitty, that I figured it just wouldn't be a good mix. So I got my old man vision readers there. I got those in a bright-ass headlamp that I wear on top of my head. It helps for making this stuff a little more visible. But I don't know. I figure it's probably another 2-3 hours. I don't care. I'm building it for fun, for relaxation, because I want to. I'm not in a pissy mood. I'm not getting pissed off. I'm not like, man, this fucking piece of shit. I will say that it's, you know, it's like, hey, you can make it a little easier to put together, you know, follow some Tamiya instructions, but, yeah, could be worse. It could be like the old Losi I put together. My JRX2 was a pain in the ass to put together. Little teeny tiny ball diffs, and their little balls in the ball diff, they were just, God, I don't know, they weren't even a 16th inch ball bearing. But, so, I'm debating if I do that Tamiya Superstock RZ, or if I go brushless with this. I'm not sure. I'll try that. I also bought a couple of real hot vintage motors that I think might be just awesome in this thing. So, well, that's enough for an update for now. I'll get back with you in the next one. So, which I'm sure will be right about now. Alright, it is now 7:30 in the morning. Didn't get much further, did I? Front suspension's done. It's smooth as glass. The steering is beautimous. I've got everything bolted into chassis. Next step's going to be steering. Actually, the next step's in the instructions call for the shocks. But I've watched a couple reviews on people that have built these cars, and they said that the shocks, not only are they a pain in the dick to build, ain't very good anyway. So I just bought some RC dong. RC AI dong. Sure. I'm going to try those. And if they suck nuts, fine, I'll buy some better shocks. But I am not a big fan of these goddamn little itty-bitty E-clips. And they're so small on the shocks that I can't see them. But what I am pretty good at doing is going across the room. In this Kyosho kit, Kyosho, however you pronounce it, they don't give you any extras. Nothing. Unless maybe there's something in the spare parts bag. But as far as like extra screws and stuff, nothing. Oh, a gasket. Some O-rings. Oh, I see one E-clip. Two E-clips. Woo, thanks. Which I have plenty of E-clips. But these things are already built and they're like $20, you know? So, whatever. So I decided this is the steering servo I'm going to run. Come on, Jake. Yeah, that's like a... I think I paid like $80-$90 for that servo. Years ago, it used to be my throttle servo in my gas-powered cars, my gasoline cars.
It's just, it's such a fast servo. I mean, I think it's like 60 degree time, I think it's like 0.07 at 6 volt, and it'll handle like 7.2. So, I mean, it's a fast, fast servo. And this car doesn't weigh much, at least from what I'm feeling right now. It doesn't seem to weigh much, so I think that steering servo will be just ducky. So, I don't know. I might keep going. I might call it quits for the night. I haven't decided, or for the day. I mean, like I said, it's 7:30 in the morning. But I'm still on my Diet Coke and water. But it's 7:30 in the morning. I might end up going and buying some beer. It's getting to be about that time. But, all right, well, I'll catch you in the next one. Well, getting a little bit closer. I ended up using the springs that came in the Kyosho kit. And I used the RC dong shocks. And, of course, they were empty. They had to be filled with fluid. But, surprisingly enough, this kit actually came with some 20-weight oil. Even though I've watched several people build these, and they're like, oh, it didn't come with oil. But the front shocks, the bottoms are a little goofy, so I had to use the Kyosho ones. Just because these things right here are a little too big, and they wouldn't fit down any A-arm properly. So, but no big deal. I did end up putting stainless steel screws in the front just because I couldn't find them in the bag. Got tired of looking, started getting annoyed. So, and it is now 8:30 in the morning. I think it's time to go to the store, get some beer, celebrate my epic win. And if you're wondering, those tires are made by Schumacher. They're just something I bought. They're a 2-inch tire. It's kind of hard to find 2-inch knobbies anymore. When you type in 2-inch tire, all you get is rock crawling tires and shit. And obviously, I don't want to put a set of mud terrains on my buggy. But I'll update with more when I get there. See you in the next one. Well, there it is. Other than paint and electronics, it's pretty much done. It is 11:45. I did take off for about a half hour, went and got some beer. So I figured it's about a 7-8 hour job. Taking my time, making sure everything's in there the way I want it. If I'd have built the shocks, that would have taken an extra hour at least, because I'm blind. But it weighs like nothing. I mean, it's an 80s race car. Feels about like the Raider, nice and light. Cool car. Not a bad build. Well, if you made it this far, give me a thumb, would you? Unless you don't like it. But you should. Alright, I am going to go with the 107 numbers. Just because that's what the original had. The re-release is a 5. It doesn't matter. But I'm going to do the box art. And the body most likely will be all white. Orange driver. Red helmet. And this here's, I mean, there's really very little you have to do to the driver. It's all decals and stuff. So, I mean, even like his visor and, you know, like right there where it says Kyosho, that actually goes on his helmet, so. Get your mind out of the gutter. Yeah, it's got some other stickers too, so when I get around to it, I'll throw decals on it. I'm not in any big rip-roaring hurry. Like I said, I haven't even figured out what I'm doing for a motor yet. Might do that RZ. Might not. I don't know. But let me know down below, what do you guys think? Should I go? I have a 4.5 turn brushless that's in my Sand Viper that's never been run. I have a 4.5 turn of that. I have the RZ motor. And here I actually have I know you can't tell, but I have an entire VXL setup that came out of my Rustler. I also have a couple of Epic motor, or excuse me, ESP motors from the early 90s. I haven't done a review on those yet, but it's something I bought off of eBay. It's something I've been wanting for a couple years, but they're I've got a 12-turn single and a 12-turn triple that I bought. And they were hot motors back in the day. I mean, they didn't last very long. I mean, they'd milk a 1,200 milliamp battery in about a minute and a half. But these days, you know, with 4,000 LiPos that'll fit in his car, that thing will run for 2 hours. But what are your recommendations? All right. Well, I guess this concludes this video, and I'll put up another one once it's all painted, but it probably won't be anytime soon. Just because I know how I am. You know, last time I built one, it took me I had that thing done for a month and a half before I painted it. And same thing with this. So. Alright, well, I'll see you in the next one, guys. Have a good one.